My name is Tarik Preston. I converted to Islam in 1988 at the age of 19. The story of my conversion to Islam is not a long story, and in many cases, how do I think Allah, God, has continued to guide me? There is another inspirational story after I entered Islam. Nevertheless, this story begins in my name. At birth, I was given a name. In the 60s, 70s, and 80s, it was not uncommon for some Americans to give their children African names. Many times, the names they chose from Africa were actually Islamic names. The same name came to my name. All my life before Islam, I periodically met other people who knew the importance of my name, and they asked me, "Do you know what your name means?" I will proudly answer as I was taught, it means the shining star. Sometimes I will include the story of the famous Tariq ibn Ziyad, who conquered Spain in the year 711, in spite of knowing these important facts. In the sense of my name, as long as I was a college student, I did not know the Islamic significance of my name. I started college at the age of 16 at the time of pre-med biology before I intended to become a doctor. I knew that if I was going to have such an important responsibility, I would need a good method in my life. During my freshman year, I tried to read the Bible, but Christianity had not begun to understand me. Studying the fine complexities of cell biology this year, many of my classmates and I confirmed our belief in the Creator and that creation was no accident, as some scientists have speculated. During spring break, I had a religious conversation with my grandmother, with whom I was very close. And, despite his being a Christian, she made a remarkable statement that I paid close attention to. She said, "I worship God and I do not worship Jesus, because I feel secure in worshiping God." She advised me to pray no more in the name of Jesus and to pray only to God. When I returned to college after this conversation, I kept praying every night before going to bed as I was taught. But I have decided that I will no longer pray in the name of Jesus and direct my prayers only to God. Once I made that decision, I started to feel guilty about lying down in bed. So I started to kneel down on the side of my bed, feeling better. Still looking for something to guide me safely in life, one day I asked God to guide me as I walked across campus. During my junior year in college, a fellow student who had converted to Islam saw me walking across campus and greeted me with "Assalamu alaikum." After growing up in Chicago in the 1970s, I had heard this greeting many times, so I replied, "Wa alaikum as-salam." Then he asked me if I was a Muslim, to which I answered, "At that time, no. I'm a United Methodist." He replied, "Oh, I thought you were Muslim because your name is Tariq." No longer after this confrontation, he came to a study session I and some other classmates were coming from, and he tried to tell us about Islam. He was very young and very new to Islam himself, so he didn't know much. But he warned us about the dangers of worshipping Jesus, the son of Mary. Indeed, it was a familiar statement, but I still didn't know much about Islam, but I learned how Muslims look, because my friend's behavior was different after his conversion. When I returned home this summer, I took a summer job as a telemarketer where I met a Muslim named Ahmed. Despite being a Puerto Rican convert, he had a different attitude toward college than my friend, so I asked him, "Are you Muslim?" He smiled and replied, "Yes, quit. Are you?" I replied, "No, I'm a United Methodist." He smiled and said angrily, "You should be a Muslim with a name like Tariq." He started talking to me about Tawheed, oneness of God. I was impressed with the concept of Islamic monotheism. Finally, he called me home and showed me a copy of the English translation of the Quran. I was very impressed by the respect he had for this book, and I asked if I could borrow it to read it. He reluctantly agreed that it was the only version of his Quran, and he strongly advised me how much respect be and place it in a place of honor in my house. I can't wait to read it. 2 weeks Later, I invited Ahmed to my house and we sat down and then talked about Islam. I informed him that I believe that the Quran is true and I want to be a Muslim. The next day we went to the Islamic Center together in Washington, D.C. and I converted to Islam. A few years after my conversion, Allah Almighty gave me the ability to study Islam at the Islamic University of Medina, where I earned an associate's degree in Arabic and a bachelor's degree in Hadith studies. I hope the story of how I came to Islam encourages others to embrace Islam. I also hope that my story encourages my fellow Muslim brothers and sisters to share their words and actions with those around them. Thanks for watching it. Please like, share and subscribe to my channel.